Good afternoon to everyone. And my name is Sagar Gemali, and I am working in Nepal Electricity Authority. And I'm looking the project, electric vehicle infrastructure development project here. And similarly, I'm taking another project to Smart Street Light Promotion Program. I'm engaging on that project also. So, I would like to thank for the organizer to organizer for providing this opportunity to share some views regarding the current status of the charging station deployment in Nepal and how NA is thinking now to speed up the development in the sector. And thank you, Shankarji. And I would like to start up. I would like to go from the current state of the power supply and demand, because many things you already have discussed, because I have seen the program outline, and many subjects they have already discussed there. So I would like to go to showing the current situation of the Nepal. And this is the current status of the power supply and demand. And I have taken this graph from the load dispatch center, and it's from 27th October 2021. And this is the actual scenario. And nowadays, we are not taking a single unit of electricity from India. Total installed capacity is 2075 megawatt, and among them IPP 1431 megawatt is there, and from NEA side it is 481. It is RVAR type, and storage 160 Kilihani first, second, and third, and about 57 megawatt of solar is already there in our INPS. And our average demand nowadays is 1060 megawatt. This is the average demand, and our average peak demand is about 1410 megawatt. This is the average peak demand, now the total surplus, the average surplus is 350 megawatt. This is the surplus energy. That's a huge amount of electricity is being surplus, and then we are sending this electricity to India if it is generated. Otherwise, we are wasting the water in the river. Okay, and like the previous slide, there are number of options are seen in our INPS, like this space where we are consuming about only 900 megawatt of electricity, and there is a possibility to charge the electric vehicle. This is the night time, and this is also the night time, and we are sourcing for the big load consumer in the, especially in the night time. And our ROR hydropower is dominated here, and most of the IPP are the ROR type, run of river type. So how much electricity they generate that have to be consumed. So, and in the peak time, it's about the 14,000, and there is the option of the peak clipping also, but nowadays our total generation capacity is far more than the peak demand. So this is the very interesting situation in Nepal. So we are in the energy surplus, and energy surplus about 24 hours. So we are searching the big load consumer, especially the industries. And for the night time, we are looking for the charging station. So we are lowering the price for the charging station. And similarly, we are encouraging the smart street light program. Street light program also we are encouraging. And induction cooking also we are working. So this is this time for NA is to surge the load. And there are a number of research are going on, or they have the number of conclusion are there. And we thought that the major electricity consumer that can balance our system, that means that can balance our system, maybe the charging station. And we especially targeted to charge the electric vehicle is nighttime. So for that, we have made a research, that means the KMIRI 2020. And this is a very good research one. And it was the previous 1 year before, but the reality is there. And the lack of charging station is the major barrier to adopt the electric vehicle in Nepal. So there are a number of barriers, and many barriers I think we have overcome on that. But the lack of charging station is pronouncing. And in Kathmandu Valley, you are seeing that the EV penetration is very good. But if you go to out of the Kathmandu Valley and other cities, and the people are not so excited in charging in electric vehicles. So we have also seen that. And any also, we are purchasing electric vehicle to operate in Kathmandu, but we are also not purchasing in other cities or out of the valley. So there was the question that either charging station first or the electric vehicle first, and then energy ministry also looking to develop this charging station. And later NEA said that yeah, so we will come in front and we'll build the charging station, we'll build the public charging station. But then we took the project, and because of the COVID-19 effect, it was little bit being delayed because the tender opening and other part being little bit delayed. And now we are, it's already awarded, and pre-construction survey is already done. And NEA is planning to develop the charging station in two phases, okay? And for the first phase, we are developing 50 numbers of the public charging stations, and every 100 kilometers, 60 to 80 kilometers, we are making the public charging stations. And we are covering 32 cities along the East-West Highway and other IOs. Like we are covering major IOs in Nepal. And all of the equipment and project under this phase first, that is owned by the NEA. And we are not only putting the charging station, we are preparing the whole charging ecosystem within this project, like the payment gateway we are making, the CMS, central monitoring system we are making, and payment method, like people can use the RFID card, or they can pay, every vehicle can go and they can pay by the QR code, that type of facilities also we are developing within this project. And more 300 charging stations will also be controlled by the same thing. That means that if a charging station owned by the private sector will be formed, and they can also be demonetized. That will also be monitored by our system. So this is the whole system, and we are putting all of the server, everything within the NEA premises. That means in our data center. And this is the first one. And in second phase, we are supporting the private sector. It may be the home charger, or it may be the urban shared charger, or it may be the the highway chargers, or it may be the commercial charger. Any private sector, they can cooperate with NEA. And in this model, the public announce is already going on, and then we are receiving the applications. In this model, NEA is providing the transformer if they need it, and we are providing the STLT line if they need it. We are providing the payment gateway or payment system, and we are giving the access to our CM system to the private charging station owners. And they have to only buy this charging station, that is the charger. They have to buy, and other physical equipment we are providing from the NEA side. And based on this model, we already started to install. And this charging station by the Tigo Group, and we have provided all of the power equipment, all of the STLT lines and other part we are providing, and they are putting this charging station, and they are getting the subsidized price. The very important thing is these private sectors charging station, they are getting the very good subsidized price from the NEA. That means the price will be very low, I'll show later. So in this model, private sector, any home charger or any home platform, we are making the methodology for the home charger, that is the provision that in the own building premises, they're managed with the two consumers at the same place, but we are making a methodology how to promote the EV chargers. So in many places, like in Birta Mod, Birat Nagar, we already provided this type of home chargers also in this model. So we are inviting from all over the country, from any commercial building or any hospital or any private sector to put the charging station. We'll cooperate in the power system, in the payment gateway and CMS part. And then anyone interested here also can give the application form. An application form can be downloaded from the any website. Our own major thing that we have designed here is we are providing the dedicated transformer and dedicated distribution network for the charging stations. And this lesson we have taken from the many in South Asia. Then we are not sharing the transformer to other consumer, and we are giving the dedicated transformer to the charging station so that the fault or any other disturbance from the other consumer may not become in the charger, and then this reflection will not go to the electric cars. So we are also cooperating with the municipalities, the transport department, provisional government to install the charging station. And provisional government, they are making the refresh center, and we are putting the charging station there. And in this model, we are working in with many municipalities like Haryana municipality. We are preparing charging station in the refresh center in the Lumini Province. Provisional government, they are preparing the 5 refresh center, and we are putting the charging station. In this model, we are cooperating with the provisional government to take the land, okay, to get the land. And and any also preparing operating modality to run charging station under private sector ownership. I already described regarding this. And another very interesting development is the tariff for the general charging stations in Nepal. And I think this tariff rate is the cheapest and lowest all over the country. And if you put the charging station in low voltage range, like 230 single phase or the three phase in single phase, then the price is 5.75 rupees per unit. But the demand charge is there for 230 kVA per month. It's very nominal. And if you compare with the domestic charge, if you compare with the domestic charge, the charge is 10 rupees per unit if you go more than 150 unit to 250. And it is 11 rupees if you go 251 to 400. Even if you go more than 400 unit, and the price is 12 rupees per unit. That means if you use the electric vehicle, then definitely the you will charge more than 400 unit, and then price will be more than 12 rupees per unit. And it is very, very higher than the general price that we are given, 5.75 rupees per unit. So the price is very lucrative for the charging station here. And if you take this general type of charging station in 11 kV, then the price is 5.6 rupees. And if you take this from the 33 kV, and it is 5.6 rupees, Nepalese rupees per unit. And this is the common for all 12 months. That means all over the year. Actually, there is the price difference in 6 months, first 6 months, whether it is the rainy season, and the price is higher in the winter season. And this general price is the common, all common for the 12 month. And if you put the time of the TUD meter there, and in 33 kV, there is the three range. It is in the peak time at night, let's see, the evening 5 to 12, and it is 7 rupees. And if you go in the night time, if the pure night time, that means in the night time, the price is very low. It is 3.7 rupees per unit. And at the daytime, it is 5.5 rupees. And similarly, the price is winter is 7 rupees at the peak time, and it is 5 rupees in other time. So this is also very low price compared to the general price. And if you take it from the 11 kV, it is also the similar one. That means it's a little bit higher than the 33 kV. And price is very low. And if you check it in 11 kV, if you charge your vehicle at night time, it is 4.2 rupees at night. Okay, so it is very, very less price. And this is the bulk price that we are given to the private sector or anyone. And this price also, this is the price for the any public charging stations also. Any private operator, he or she want to operate the charging station, and they can add 20% in this base price, and they can add 20% as their benefit, and this is 20% is the gross margin for the private charging station operators. The charging station operation modality is under preparation. Currently, it can be operated by the smart meter or TOD meter provided by NEA. Currently, we are providing the TOD meter, and then based on the TOD meter, we are giving the bill to the private charging owner. And later, we are making the modality, and they can come in our the server system, and they can pay from our QR code, or they can pay from the RFID. I think it's under construction. It may took 6 to 9 months to complete all of this thing. And there is another model by the ERC, that is automatic swap card based tariff structures. And in this structure, the demand charge is not included, that is avoided. And the price is here. And for the automatic swap card, we are making the RFID card. And based on that, anybody can go and charge in our public charging station. And the price is little bit cheaper for the public transportation. Like if Saza will become, Saza Yatra will become, price will be less. And if any other private sector or any car owner or other commercial vehicle will come, then the price is little bit different. And based on that, we are making the different type of the charging stations. And it is also the headless. I think this price is the cheapest among all. And I would like to explain about the public charging stations and the current status of the development. And you can see here, and we have three categories we are making. And before choosing these categories, we have made a research in the market. What type of vehicles are available here? What type of AC charging protocol are there? What type of the DC charging protocol was there? And we have seen that most of the car, they have the CCS2 type of charging protocols in DC, and they have the type 2 AC type of charging protocols. And most of the car or the vehicle or bus or micros, they're coming from the China. They have the GBT protocols, and they have the AC protocol by GBT AC protocols. And some of the cars at that time, they have the TADEMO protocols. And based on that, we have divided the number of the chargers. And in each of our chargers, there are three guns, and two guns are the DC chargers, and one gun for the AC chargers. And the capacity of the single gun is 120 kilowatt. This is a liquid cooled cable, and the maximum capacity of this cable is 120 kilowatt. That means that if any vehicle or any bus come with 120 kilowatt hour battery capacity, then we can charge in 1 hour. And based on this, we are preparing. And in CCS type, there are two CCS guns or 60 kilowatt. If two car will be there, then the power will be divided by 60 kilowatt and 60 kilowatt, and the AC is separate. The whole total capacity of the charger is 120 kilowatt. And the remaining 56 kilowatt, we are thinking to make the charging stations for the bikes or the e-rickshaw. We are planning for that in the major cities like Paras Bus Park in Chikan. We are thinking to develop the charging station for the e-rickshaw and other also in the major cities. The remaining power, and then we are providing a dedicated 200 kVA transformer here. And as I already said, this is the whole ecosystem for the charging station, for the upcoming charging station, even by operating by the private sector. Like we are providing the dedicated transformer here, and charging station is there. And I already said the charger type, and there will be the central monitoring system. And we are making the server here in NEA data center, and there will be the mobile application, and it will be connected with the Iseba or Khalti to pay the money, and the information will be from in server, and then there is another RFID card also, and they can charge money from the RFID, and we'll provide that card from the NEA. And this is the whole ecosystem. Any charger coming after this installation, after this software execution, and they will be connected in this software. Or the CME system, and we will monitor all of the charging station based on this, and we will collect all the money from this system. And private owner also get 20% benefit from directly from our system. And the major idea of this 50 charger station is connecting major cities with the e-vehicles. If you are going out of valley or if you want to travel from one city to another city, and there should not be any hindrance of the charging station or any hindrance of the unavailability of the charging station. So we want to connect all of the cities with the charging stations. So in every 60 to 80 kilometers, we are providing CCS type fast charger and GPT type fast charger, and similar to the AC chargers also there. So in every 60 to 80 kilometer, and the car owner will get the charging station, and they can book the charge from any time. They can book the time charging station, and they can go at that time and they can charge. They need not to be stay there. If could not get the time at their selected time, they can go to the another charging station. So, and yeah, solution for charging station also for electric buses also. So this is very interesting. Previously, we thought about to provide the charging station solution for the car that we have designed for the 60 kilowatt system by putting this liquid cooled cable, and we upgraded to 120 kilowatt output. By a single gun can operate 120 kilowatt output, and integrated payment gateway for all payment option, wallet, credit, debit card, and net banking, etc. are integrated. And I already said that in a central monitoring system, everything we are going to be. And another interesting thing is the annual maintenance contract we have provided. That means that for the 5 years, the contractor will, the person or technician from the contractor will sit together with the technical person from the NEA in the central monitoring system. We'll make a central monitoring stations, and for the all 24 hours there will be two persons, one from the contractor side, another from the NA side. By doing so, we want to exchange the knowledge, and anything, any disturbance or any problem form in any charger, then the service have to be provided within 36 hours. 36 hours, the solution should be there, and we are taking the some bank guarantee. If the contractor will not perform that of that means the maintenance correctly, then we'll cut some money from there. So for the 5 years, we are catching this that means the contractor. So yeah, we thought that during these 5 years we will learn all of the maintenance. So based on that, we make this this part, and anytime the real time data will be come in the central stations, and we can watch which car is from there and how much electricity has gone, any problem is there or not, that type of things we are doing. And another is overall solution for STLT line, so that we can decrease the fault. Let's say the in roadside there may be some electrical faults. To minimize that, we are providing the dedicated line from the 11 kV line. We are taking the trunk line, and there will be the dedicated transformer for that. And the current status of this project, pre-construction survey is completed. It's not active, it's completed. We already chosen the place, and the contractor has already started to construct the product. It's already in the construction, that means the manufacturing, and material are under manufacturing. And we expect that all of the project will be completed at the end of, it's June 2022, I think, because the project timeline is that. Next, and these are the locations. These are the locations that we are providing the charging stations here, and we are covering all over the country. And every 60 to 80 kilometers, there is the CCS type charging station, GPT type, minimum two guns are there currently, and we are thinking to increase the number of chargers also. Accordingly, we are cooperating the rural municipalities. And we are taking the bus park, which are the modern bus park, which are connected to the major highway. We are choosing that, and we are choosing the refresh center also. And sometime we are taking the dedicated place for the charging station provided by the rural municipalities. And we are covering whole country. We are covering whole country. And at the conclusion, completion of the 50 charging station within the targeted time is essential to each sector, definitely. And we are preparing for making the charging station for e-rickshaw and bikes so that they can get the subsidized price, because these type of vehicles are basically used by the low earning people, that means the low range people. So we are designing the public charging station for these small size vehicles also. And home charger and commercial charger needed to be connected to CMS system. So we are preparing on that part also, so that if you charge your vehicle in at your own home, then you have to get that lower price. That you already seen, we are giving the price 3 rupees per unit also. That type of charging, that type of tariff also need to be get by the EV owner. And that is another part. And we are encouraging private sector for the EV charge development. We are providing the transformer and other system to them. And and in conclusion of all of these things, to speed up the sector, there should be the dedicated department to look after all of this e-mobility, EV charger, or to speed up all of the sector. Thank you.